Hello, 8th graders. I hope you're having a good day. So welcome back to Unit 2. We're going to talk about three things in Unit 2. The first one is prohibition, the second one is obligation, and the last one is suggestion. So please check it out.
Alright, so there will be three things that we are going to talk about in the second unit of English. The first one is obligation or something that you must do. Jadi yang pertama kita akan membahas tentang kewajiban, bagaimana cara kalian memberitahu suatu kewajiban ke orang lain atau memberitahu sesuatu yang orang lain harus lakukan. Alright? The second of all is we're going to talk about the expression of prohibition or giving prohibition to talk about something that you can't or mustn't do. Jadi yang kedua, kita akan membicarakan tentang bagaimana caranya kamu melarang seseorang untuk melakukan sesuatu. Yeah, and the third one is suggestion, okay, or something that you should do. Jadi kita juga akan mempelajari bagaimana caranya kamu memberi saran atau memberi nasihat kepada temanmu tentang apa saja yang seharusnya dia lakukan. Alright, so now let's go to the next slide. So let's read the dialogue together and please pay attention to the underlined sentence. Let's start with Kevin. I'm sorry, Mom, I accidentally broke your vase. Terus dilanjut Mrs. Tia. Oh my God, Kevin, I always remind you, don't play the ball in the house. Do you remember it? Yes, Mom, I'm so sorry. I didn't play the ball. It fell down the stairs. The stairs were slippery. I think it was slippery because you wore socks in the house. Now listen to me. You must clean the broken vase and remove the trash. All right, Mom. Next time, you should be more careful when walking on the stairs. Ya, jadi di sini ada tiga kalimat yang di garis bawah ya. So there are three underlined sentences. The first one is don't play the ball in the house. Second is you must clean the broken vase and remove the trash. Third is next time you should be more careful when walking on the stairs. Okay, here we go. Now let's discuss the underlined sentences. The first one, don't play the ball in the house. That sentence is an example of giving prohibition, or yeah, that's the example of expression of prohibition, ya. Jadi itu adalah contoh memberikan sebuah larangan yang artinya jangan bermain bola di dalam rumah, okay? And the second underlined sentence is you must clean the broken vase and remove the trash. That is an example of giving obligation, yang artinya adalah kamu harus membersihkan vas-vas yang pecah ini dan dibuang ke tong sampah, ya. Jadi itu merupakan contoh ekspresi kamu mewajibkan seseorang untuk melakukan sesuatu, ya. And then next time you should be more careful when walking on the stairs, yang artinya adalah lain kali kamu harus lebih hati-hati ketika jalan di atas tangga atau jalan di tangga, ya. So that is a form of suggestion. Itu adalah example of suggestion atau contoh memberi saran kepada orang lain. Yeah, so I hope it's clear on the difference between prohibition, obligation, and also suggestion. Okay, moving on. Now let's talk about the first one, obligation or something you must do. Okay, so here we go. Obligation is stated in the present, past, and in the future. Yang artinya adalah kita bisa membicarakan kewajiban di masa sekarang, di masa lampau, yang kewajiban yang membahas kewajiban yang pernah kita lakukan atau kewajiban yang akan kita lakukan in the future atau kewajiban yang seseorang harus lakukan di masa depan menanggapi kondisi sekarang, ya. Let's talk about obligation in the present. So there are four expressions that you can use. The first one is I have to, the second one is I must. The third one is, it is obligatory that. The last one is, it is necessary that, blah, blah, blah. Okay? So, these are the examples. Ini adalah contohnya, ya. When someone says that, I'm hungry, so the man says that he's hungry, naturally, he will make an obligation, ya. Jadi, ketika seseorang lapar, mereka pasti akan mewajibkan diri mereka untuk makan, ya. So, these are the examples of the sentences using obligation. I have to eat breakfast soon. Atau, it is obligatory that I eat a lot of food. Artinya adalah, saya harus sarapan segera. Satu lagi, merupakan suatu kewajiban untuk saya makan makanan yang banyak. Ya. So, these are the examples of the obligation. The next one, let's say there is a dance audition atau ada seleksi dance, and then your friend told you, I have a dance audition tomorrow. Aku ada ini loh, seleksi dance loh besok. And then, as a friend, you will oblige him or her to train hard. Ya, kalian pasti akan mewajibkan mereka untuk bekerja keras dong ya, atau latihan keras dong ya. So, the examples are, you must train hard for the audition. Atau, it is necessary that you master the dance moves. Yang artinya adalah, kamu harus latihan keras untuk audisinya, atau penting sekali untuk kamu menghafal semua, atau menguasai semua gerakan-gerakannya. Now, moving on. Obligation stated in the past. So, one expression that we can use to state obligation in the past is I had to. Ya, apabila kita ingin menceritakan kewajiban kita di masa lalu, we use I had to. Okay? So, these are the examples. For example, I had to study hard to pass the math test. Nah, artinya adalah kemarin saya harus bekerja keras loh, saya harus belajar keras loh untuk lulus di ulangan MTK atau ujian MTK. Or the other example is I had to read a lot of books for the project, yang artinya adalah saya harus membaca banyak sekali buku untuk menyelesaikan proyek ini. Okay, moving on. Yeah, so obligation in the future, the expression is I'll have to atau I will have to. Okay, contohnya, misalnya nih, di gambar bisa kalian lihat ya, ada satu wanita atau perempuan yang uangnya habis, dompetnya habis. So, the obligation that we will tell her is she'll have to borrow money, yang artinya ya dia mau nggak mau harus segera pinjam uang, or she will have to borrow money, ya. So, these are the examples of obligation stated in the past, present, and the future. Okay, now for the homework on Cambridge book, page 47. So there is a listening practice. Yeah, the audio and the Google form for the homework is already in your Google Classroom. Please check it in English class 8.1 until 8.7 ya. Jadi untuk PR, nomor 1 sampai nomor 8 sudah ada di Google form yang sudah ter-upload di Google Classroom. Please check it, okay? The audio is also uploaded in the Google Classroom. Yeah, audionya juga sudah terunggah atau sudah terupload di situ. So please check that out. Yeah. Moving on, let's talk about prohibition or something that you can't or mustn't do. All right. So here are the expressions that you can use to express prohibition. It is prohibited to, you aren't permitted to, you aren't allowed to, it is forbidden to, yang semua artinya adalah ini dilarang, kamu dilarang untuk atau kamu tidak diizinkan untuk, ya. The next one is you mustn't or don't, yang artinya adalah kamu tidak boleh atau don't itu adalah jangan, okay? So those are the examples of expressing prohibition. So these are the examples. Ada tiga tanda ya di sini. The first one, ya, tanda kamu nggak boleh berjabat tangan. Ya, because of the risk of COVID-19, it is prohibited to shake hands, artinya tidak diperbolehkan untuk berjabat tangan, or you aren't allowed to shake hands, yang artinya adalah kamu tidak boleh untuk berjabat tangan, karena berjabat tangan ini beresiko menularkan virus corona, ya. Or the next one, in a cinema, you aren't permitted to take photos, yang artinya adalah kamu tidak diperbolehkan untuk mengambil foto, or it is forbidden to take pictures, atau yang artinya mengambil foto itu dilarang. Okay, moving on, to maintain your health. Okay, nah, to maintain your health itu maksudnya untuk menjaga kesehatanmu. Yeah, there are two expressions that you can use. You mustn't smoke, yang artinya adalah kamu tidak boleh merokok, or don't smoke, jangan merokok, ya. Yeah? So these are the examples of prohibition that you can use, okay? So if you have any question, feel free to ask me, okay? In the WhatsApp, in Instagram, up to you, okay? Let's move on. So another homework for you that is already in the Google Form. Nah, untuk PR nomor 9 sampai 13, ini juga sudah ada di Google Form yang ter-upload ya di Google Classroom. So it's a grammar practice. All you have to do is to use the word must or mustn't in the sentences. For example, kayak nomor satu nih, I mustn't be late for work, yang artinya adalah saya tidak boleh telat bekerja, atau saya tidak boleh telat masuk kantornya, seperti itu ya. Now, all you have to do is to continue number 2 until number 6 untuk menyelesaikan nomor 9 sampai nomor 13 di dalam Google Form yang sudah terupload. Okay? And another homework, number 14 until 18, it's a writing practice. Please make the prohibitions based on the picture below. Okay? Jadi bisa kalian lihat tanda-tanda larangan di sini dari nomor 14 sampai nomor 18. Tugas kalian adalah membuat larangan tersebut ya. For example, jangan berjalan di atas rumput, jangan buang sampah sembarangan, tidak boleh membawa motor, tidak boleh membawa HP, dan tidak boleh membawa makanan dan minuman. Ya, cari tahu sendiri ya kalimat Inggrisnya ya. I think you can do it. Okay, now let's talk about the last one, suggestion or something that you should do. Alright, so there are some ways to offer suggestions, such as I suggest you should blah blah blah, or I suggest that you should blah blah blah, atau langsung aja loncat you should blah 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 blah, atau pakai I think you should, dan kita juga boleh bilang you shouldn't, itu maksudnya adalah kamu tidak seharusnya melakukan ini, atau kamu tidak seharusnya merasakan ini atau melalui ini, ya. So these are the examples, okay? So the first one, when you are very tired because of studying so hard, the suggestion that your friend will give to you is, jadi kalau kalian kecapean, pasti teman kalian akan menyarankan seperti ini. For example, you look tired, you should take a rest. Or I suggest that you should take a rest. Artinya adalah, kamu terlihat kecapean nih, kamu seharusnya istirahat. Or, langsung aja, saya menyarankan kamu untuk segera istirahat. Okay? Or the second one, we can see there is a sad SpongeBob face there. Nah, kira-kira saran apa yang akan kalian berikan kepada SpongeBob? Okay, so here we go. Hey SpongeBob, you shouldn't feel sad. Artinya adalah, hey SpongeBob, kamu tidak seharusnya merasakan kesedihan. Or, I think you should cheer up SpongeBob. Atau, kamu harus semangat SpongeBob, jangan sedih-sedih terus. Seperti itu ya. So these are the examples of suggestions that you can use. Alright, moving on. So for the last homework, number 19 until number 25, it's a grammar practice. You can check it on Cambridge book, page 97, part C. All you have to do is to fill in the blanks with should or shouldn't and add the verb from the box. Ada tiga verb ya di situ, go, watch, sama where. The Google form is also uploaded in the Google Classroom. Jadi silakan cek di Google Classroom total PR kalian untuk latihan kalian hari ini. Writing practice, listening practice, grammar practice, itu ada 25 soal ya. So please check it out and please do it carefully, okay? Ya, ini karena demi pembelajaran kalian, so do it by yourself, jangan nyontek ya, kalau bisa ya. Alright, so yeah, I think that's all that we can talk about in the audio, in the video, I mean. So, okay, I'll close this one.
Oke, sekian dari materi bab 2 hari ini ya. Jadi jika kalian masih ada pertanyaan, silahkan tanyakan ke Sir melalui WhatsApp atau DM Instagram, it's up to you. Jangan lupa kerjakan tugasnya ya, ada 25 soal. Tugasnya sudah ada di Google Classroom. Please do it by yourself, jangan nyontek karena tugasnya ini penting untuk latihan kalian ya. Tolong jangan malu-malu ya kalau ada pertanyaan, okay? So, tetap stay healthy, stay safe, and I'll see you everyone soon, okay? Bye-bye!